unfortunately. Okay. Let's start recording again.
Also, I want this scene. If something can go wrong, it will go wrong. So
probably will, yeah. Okay. And these are gonna be pistons. And then on top is gonna be observers. So I should probably get some of those. How to make observers again? Kinda forgot. Observer. Here it is. Oh, that's easy. So, cobblestone. And redstone. And nether quartz. So, I think it's like, oh, where do you put the stones? Like this. Nether quartz goes here. Redstone goes here. And the cobblestone is like this. I hate those pistons too. But yeah, I was just really hoping people would be reasonable. It's like, that is never ever the case. It's so sad. Like, never ever, ever, not even once, from the people that I had brought up before, have ever been reasonable about anything. They're always, everyone's always like extremely argumentative, and everybody has to be right about everything to validate their music degree, I guess. Because you go to music school for way longer than you would to be any kind of doctor or scientist, and people just trash on you because your profession is subjective by nature.
Gotta have that.
Unfortunately. Like, you can't quantify someone disliking your music because it's not what they like. So you can't really have an opinion that goes against theirs. I should have some slaps.
Yeah, this is mostly why I hated literature class. since forever. It's like, yeah.
That's not what the author intended.
And I'm like, yeah, okay, but like having some expert tell you that he meant that is okay up till the point where he tells you that he meant that. Not probably meant that. No, the author meant that.
Even though we have no idea what he actually meant.
Not only do we have no idea, if you somehow come up with an explanation like, you know what, maybe he wasn't feeling like exceptionally depressed, and that's why he uses this tone and these colors in his description of that in this poem. Maybe he was just feeling reminiscent. Maybe he was this or that.
No.
Someone, some critic, wrote in some book that he felt that, and that's what you're supposed to write on the exam paper, otherwise, bam, fail.
Every single time.
You fail, or you make your point as best as it can be made, and you only get half the points because you didn't cite any sources, or you didn't... Like, okay, but it's just all coming back to the fact that you go to school to memorize stuff, not to learn stuff.
Well, if you don't memorize things for the company that you work for, you're useless. So I guess that's the lesson they're trying to teach you. You're useless.
More or less.
Is this right?
I mean, what good is an employee who cannot remember what he's supposed to do?
You're not wrong. I guess that employee would be trying to be his own employee, and you can't have that. You can't have competition. It's bad for business.
I mean, I understand the whole, you know, not everyone can be a boss or an entrepreneur. I get that. But they're just trying so hard to squeeze all the initiative out of you.
Because if you have initiative, that means that the balance will be broken. And you will have figured out how to make, like, real money yourself. And you don't have to depend on them anymore. And if more people knew that, or knew how to do that, then they would lose a lot of their workers. Cheap workers, at that.
In a way, it's kind of healthy. Because If anyone can just become a boss, right, and they're aware and nobody's suppressing their wish to be the best, as in rule over other people,
yes.
If no one's doing that, then
it upsets the
no one will really have incentive to do anything else but work towards being a boss. So,
oh no, no you
garbage
have people.
Men, bye.
No. You have natural people who don't want to take that initiative themselves. There are people out there that are perfectly A-okay with living their entire lives in service of someone else. And like, it functions naturally. And it's a symbiotic relationship. Them and their boss and the people that they, I guess, go to work for. But it doesn't stop there. You can't just have those people who are willing to work for you. You also have to have the people who need to be subjugated by you at all costs, because you can't have competition. Competition is bad. Unless you control that competition.
No. Well, then it's not really competition, it's just
people, yeah.
I mean, it's competition in the eyes of the public, so they think they have a choice, but
wait, I just figured it out.
It's pretty much the reason why glasses and lenses are so like, fucking expensive, because there's like one guy owning like 90% of all the brands.
Yes, that's always been a thing.
Oh fuck, I'm dead. I'm so dead.
What happened?
I fell in fucking love on my own house, and all my items are gone.
What?
Everything.
What did you have on you?
I don't remember.
Oh, did you have your diamonds on you?
Nah.
No, then you're fine.
I think I had...
It's only a big deal when you have when you're at the diamond enchanted level and you lose like a fortune pick or something.
I had some dark wood.
Infinite.
Dark oak wood. Some stupid stone sword.
Not only a stone, not even an iron sword. Yeah, you didn't lose anything though. It's fine.
Oh shit.
Never mind. Sounds you didn't lose something.
I lost like 29 iron ore, but that's fine. All that bad.
So yeah.
How the hell did that happen, though?
Where were you?
In my house. I was just, like, I was trying to make a lava pit for my, chimney. But somehow I managed to put the lava block on top of an already existing lava block, and it spilled, but it didn't really spill. I have no idea how it fell in, though.
I could kind of guess how you miscalculated how lava would work, but I have no idea how you fell in.
Same.
More lava.
I mean, I could just do it again. Like 21.
Yeah. You were fine.
but had the insight of putting everything into a chest, all my andesite, granite, gravel for some reason.
Gravel is good.
Oh, eat pollen!
You can make
my dark oak wood.
Yeah. You can gravel used to be like the most useless block in the game, but then they made it so that gravel is a necessary ingredient for a recipe for making concrete. So it's pretty good now. I used to hate it.
Why is concrete good?
It's a non-textured color block, so it's really good for building.
Wait, so it's just a gray block?
No, it can be any color, but there's no textures on it, so it's just like a plain, like, whatever color you pick block.
Ah, okay.
So it's really good for building. Let's just put this here. Wait a minute. Do this.
Yeah, I somehow managed to lose, like, almost nothing, which is a record for me.
It's pretty top tier, yeah. I think the last time I got killed by lava, I managed to hop out in time and water the area. I watered the lava, but I didn't put myself out, so I ended up dying from burning. But it was in an area that didn't have any lava, so I still kept. I was able to make it back in time to get all that. Oh, that wasn't cobblestone. It was andesite. Okay, so the first auto farm is completely done this time. Now we're gonna move on to the melon and watermelon. No, watermelon and pumpkin.
Automated?
Yes. All of them are going to be automated.
Boy.
And if you want to learn how to make it, I'm recording a video right now, so step by step. Some of this stuff away. I'm kind of... Oh, yeah. Hoppers. Three hoppers. Each. Which means I also need chest. Which I think I put in the wood. Yeah, I did. Only one chest. More than that. Also have this tripwire hook I don't really need right now. Redstone torch. Right now. Water bucket I really don't need, but whatever. Okay. Making chests. Lots and lots of chests. 8? 16 chests. How many hoppers? Oops. That's too many. Three hoppers. Three more. Crap. Did it again. I didn't mean to do that. I did it again. Whatever. One, two, three. One, two, three. And I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. Three, three, three. And they're all going to feed into this chest. To put it inside of here, you hold down shift or whatever your crouch button is, so that you can put it on here without opening up the chest. Which is good. And that connects to this hopper, and that connects to this hopper, so they all feed into this hopper, which feeds into this. So if you throw something in here, it goes into this hopper, and it feeds in here. So. And then we just do it 2 times. Yeah.
Oh, are you kidding me? My house is on fire.
Wait, what?
My house is on fire, help. Send help.
I guess I'll come over here.
My goddamn house is burning, how do I stop it?
Just punch whatever blocks are on fire. How is it on fire?
I have lava downstairs and it spread upstairs somehow.
Why did you put lava in your house?
Because it's fun.
If you don't know how to gate off the lava, then that's just a health hazard.
I'm ruined. I'm actually ruined.
I don't think I'm
gonna Everything's burning! Everything!
I should have took speed potions. Should probably go do that.
And I'm about to die.
What did you do?
I put lava in the house and now it's burning!
Why would you put lava in a wooden house?
Because I didn't think it would... Like, it was next to stone. I didn't think it would spread to friggin'...
No,
yeah, everything's on fire.
That is not how it... Just punch the bricks or blocks that are on
Once?
Fire. Just hold punch with your fist until the lava...
Everything is on fire, Sarka. My house is like half burned.
I'm coming as fast as I can.
I think you're too late.
It's too late. But some of your house isn't wood. Some of it's just stone.
Yeah, this fire is spreading faster than I can put it out.
Just keep going until I get there.
Well, that's one way to... I'm dead.
Do you have a water bucket?
I do.
You should probably put that on the ground as you try to put out the fire.
Well, that's one way to learn a lesson.
Yeah. If you don't know how to contain the... Like... The lava waterfall I had in the back of my enchanting. Oh god, it is on fire. Holy crap.
Everything's on fire.
Oh no. I'm gonna try. We'll see how far I can get. Thank goodness you have the scaffolding around. Oh my god, it's lagging. What did you do?
I fell. I only had one heart.
Okay, let's see if I can try. Fire spreads so freaking fast.
Right.
Oh, I'm gonna put my water book on. This is not a woodland mansion I want to be a part of right now. Go away! Water actually won't put it out, you have to punch it. I think that's everything. No, no, it's not.
No,
it's not.
One more. No!
Fire spread too strong. Okay, oh my god, there's still one more. But I think it's isolated, so it's fine. Okay. I hope you learned your lesson. Playing with fire is bad in a wooden house. Jeez. Okay.
Okay, how do I get rid of the water now?
Where's the source block? There it is. Do you have your bucket?
I have water in it.
Oh.
Let me go empty it.
I'll just get rid of the source block. It's gone. Well, most of the house is still intact. But your flooring needs to be redone on the second floor. I would recommend making your flooring out of stone on the bottom and then put the wood on top so that you don't lose the floor entirely. Oh, I see what you were doing.
Yep.
You need to put the lava down one more and cover it up so that it's like the lava will like set things ablaze that's above it or like kind of sort of adjacent to it, so you can't really just leave it hanging out. I put lava in my base underneath the bookshelf, but I made sure to line the lava above it with like orange glass so that it's not gonna set anything on fire. Alternatively, if you want a fireplace, you can put netherrack right here and then light it with the flint and steel and it'll be an